Hey guys, welcome back. Bhagyashri here from domainracer.com, and in today's topic I am going to explain you about how to set up and configure W3 Total Cache plugin for your WordPress website. It will help you to reduce size of your pages, improve your site SEO and speed up your WordPress website. Let's get started by installing and activating W3 Total Cache. So login into your WP admin dashboard and go to plugin section. Now click on add new button and here search for W3 Total Cache plugin. Now here click on install now button, but if you have installed another caching plugin, then disable it before activating W3 Total Cache plugin to avoid conflict between two cache plugin. You can't keep two cache plugin activated at same time. So here click on install now button and then click on activate. So here we have successfully installed and activated W3 Total Cache plugin. We have divided the configuration setting in two parts. So in current part I am going to explain you about general setting, and in next part I am going to explain you about each configuration setting in detail, which is very important. So remember to watch the second part of this video for further setting. Now go ahead and let's start configuring W3 Total Cache general setting. For that, go to performance and click on general setting. Now here you have to do 13 numbers of different setting. Before we proceed further, let's do website speed test using pingdom test tool. So in new tab, open pingdom speed test tool. From dashboard, access your site, copy the URL and paste it here. Select the server from where you are going to test from. For demonstration, I am going to test it from Germany and then click on start test. Scroll down and see the result. So here, before W3 cache, configuration and setting. Our performance grade is B90. Page size is 118 KB. Load time 586 milliseconds and request 11. Now keep this aside, we need it later to compare the before and after W3 cache configuration and setting. Now go back to general setting. The first thing you need to configure is W3 Total Cache general setting. This tab enable and disable all the features which will configure. And in second part of this video I am going to configure each setting in detail. So let's start with preview mode. Preview mode allows you to test changes before deploying them to your live site. So just ignore this. We will going through the setting and enable only those that we need. Move towards next setting, which is page cache. This is the most important features of W3 Total Cache plugin. Page cache alone will massively improve your site performance. So definitely enable page cache. For the method, you should choose disk enhance method and then click on save setting and purge cache. Purge cache will clear the stored static version of your pages and forcing WordPress plugin to store refresh pages that include your new updates. Now scroll down to the next setting, which is minify. Minify can compress your site code without losing any of its functionality. So to improve page load time, enable minify cache. Select minify mode as manual, minify cache method as disk, HTML minifier default, JS minifier default, CSS minifier default, and then click on save setting and purge cache. For further setting, watch second part of this video. Now let's move towards the next setting, which is opcode cache. Opcode cache only available with pro version. So if you have pro version, then enable opcode cache and test your site performance. So for me it's not available, so skip this and move towards next setting, which is database cache. Database cache means your database where all of the actual data for your post pages and everything is stored. It can improve your database performance and reduce the time it takes to create post pages and RSS feeds. But if you are on shared hosting, it can actually slow down your site offloading too much work to your server CPU. So if you are on shared hosting, leave it disabled. If you have a dedicated server or VPS server, you can enable database cache. So here I'm using shared hosting, so I'm not going to enable database cache, and then click on save setting and purge cache. I recommend you, if you are using dedicated server or VPS, you can enable database cache. Now scroll down to the next setting. Which is object cache. Object cache is another one that may or may not play well with shared hosting. It's worth trying, but if you have enabled object cache and notice your WordPress admin dashboard running slowly, you have to disable object cache. But now enable it. After enabling object cache, if you see your WordPress admin dashboard running slowly, you have to disable object cache again. Select object cache method as disk. Click on save setting and purge cache. For further setting of object cache, don't forget to watch the second part of this video. Now scroll down to next setting, which is browser cache. Browser cache speed up your site by caching static resources in your visitor browser by eliminating the need to constantly reload static content. So enable browser cache, then click on save setting and purge cache. In next part of this video, I have explained and configured each method in more detail. So for cache setting, don't forget to watch second part of this video. Scroll down to next setting, which is CDN. If you are using Cloudflare Content Delivery Network, you don't need to configure it here. If you are using Mac CDN, then enable CDN, enter type of your CDN, enable FSD CDN, and then click on save setting. So here I'm using Cloudflare, so I'm going to skip CDN setting. Scroll down to next setting, which is reverse proxy. Reverse proxy are an advanced concept that generally require private hosting because Varnish server are designed for very large site with high traffic. So I'm going to skip this. Now move towards next, which is monitoring. Monitoring is used to connect server monitoring function. So you don't need to configure it. Just ignore monitoring setting. Scroll down to fragment cache. Fragment cache reduces execution time for common operation. It increases overall loading speed by up to 60%. So you have to enable fragment cache and select fragment cache method as disk. Then click on save setting and purge cache. But if you don't want to do it, it's not necessary setting. Scroll down to next setting, which is license. If you have purchased the pro version of W3 Total Cache plugin, then enter license key here. So I'm going to skip this also. Move towards next setting, which is miscellaneous. This is also not necessary, so just ignore this setting and move towards next. Next setting is debug. Unless you are actively trying to debug your site, you should leave all the debug option disabled. They will only add unnecessary code to your site. So I'm going to skip debug setting also. Actually these settings are not necessary, so move towards next setting, which is import and export setting, and I think this is the last setting. Once you done all with your setting in W3 Total Cache, you can backup your W3 Total Cache setting using import and export setting option. So this is all about how to configure and set up W3 Total Cache plugin. But I just explained general setting. You will need to configure each method in more detail. So for that, follow the second part of this video.